Everyone, I'm Grace from Malaysia. I hope you are doing well. Today, I'm going to share about tongue assessment with all of you. So, how can we analyze the pharyngogenesis of a patient tongue photo accurately? This needs to be learned through a professional tongue diagnosis class. 2 years ago, I have been learning the modern tongue diagnosis online class. Let me share with you a typical tongue assessment case study today. Well, let's get started to analyze this patient who have acute abdominal pain. The main complaints of this patient are abdominal pain, diarrhea, and bloating. As we can see from the tongue photo, the color of the tongue is pale and moss. From the perspective of Chinese medicine, the body of the patient is cold and dampness. The patient told us that she took raw vegetable and fruit salads as her dinner recently. From the tongue photo, we can analyze that the patient has spleen yang deficiency and stagnation of stomach qi. Spleen does not like cold food or drinks, whereas warm food or drinks are more preferable. Therefore, our spleen yang will get harmed if we take excessive of cold food or drinks, and this can cause acute abdominal pain, diarrhea, and bloating happen. Well, not only that, we also can see the patient having liver blood deficiency from the tongue photo. Let's talk about what are the symptoms of liver blood deficiency that we can see usually. These symptoms include dizziness, blurred vision, low menstrual flow in women, and many more. The patient was agree with that as she told us earlier, she has a history of falling red blood cell. The tongue photo also shows that this patient has kidney yang deficiency, which will cause her lower back pain. This is also one of her main complaints. Overall, the patient is facing weak of yang qi, so the patient will feel of cold and lack of energy. From the photo of tongue, we also can know that her emotional is in anxiety and tension. After we knew the causes of abdominal pain towards this patient, Chinese medicine will adopt the methods of warming yang to dispel cold and invigorate the spleen to dispel dampness. The Moxibustion method is more suitable for this patient. Well, let's look at the photo of the second follow-up visit. We can see that the tongue is no longer so pale, and also the abdominal pain, diarrhea, and bloating have been cured. Please forgive me for not being able to point out which place of the tongue photo to see these problems, because this is related to the intellectual property of Dr. Ng. But if you are interested to learn modern tongue diagnosis online class, there will be a class coming soon in September. So if you would like to know more, you can always contact Grace for more information. That's all for today's tongue reading. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.